Hey, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Patrick, your most favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right today. Praise God, praise God. I've been trying to get on here and make a video for the last little while, but the Lord had arrested me from doing that, and I had to give a brother a call and talk to him with a word from the Lord. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters, if the Lord would use you. And anyway, you know, the Lord has given me so many words and all that stuff, and I don't usually do videos and say, oh, the Lord told me this and it came to pass and all that. But you know, these things are done that people might know there is a God in heaven. You know, it's not just for us. A lot of times, you know, people want words and all that, and it's for our own, you know, edification and stuff, but God does these things so that the world may know that there is a God in heaven. Signs and wonders to follow Christians, as Jesus said. Signs and wonders would follow. These signs shall follow those who believe. You know, we're supposed to be doing this, you know, casting out demons, speaking in new tongues, laying hands on the sick and they shall recover. These are the things that is the normal life of a believer supposed to be. You know, as Sid Rawls says, you know, these are naturally supernatural. Anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, all the road signs that the Lord has given me that I've made videos about, they're road signs, a sign pointing to what's coming into the line for us, for the church, is the rapture, the true born-again church. The end of the line for the world, of course, is the tribulation. And then, of course, if they survive through that to the second coming of Christ, the end of the line is the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. These are road signs pointing to the way, that the way the Lord shows me. And the Lord deals with people in different ways. Like in the Old Testament, you read the prophets and you read in the book of Acts where people had dreams and visions and all that. God talks in various ways to various people, all pointing to Jesus Christ, to Yeshua HaMashiach. The spirit of prophecy is Jesus Christ, the Bible says. It all points to, all road signs lead to the narrow way and the straight gate and narrow way to the Lord Jesus Christ. Anyway, brothers and sisters, you know, I'd given that word from a dream. It wasn't a word, but a dream I had of the bowling pins. And the first pin to fall, you know, I want to say this. All the road signs I've seen in the past, brothers and sisters, were like you're driving down a highway, you know, and then you see a road sign that says, you know, next exit, McDonald's or whatever, Exxon Gas, whatever it is. It's like that, spread out. But these bowling pins, as the Lord was just telling me just a few minutes ago when I was praying, and that the Lord showed me that those bowling pins are very close. They're not like those road signs that are spread out. This is in quick succession, brothers and sisters. That's what I want to tell you from the Lord, to sound the alarm. You know, one person who, and you know, somebody that just recently started watching my videos, it's you know, believes it's fear-mongering to tell people that Jesus is coming back to judge the quick and the dead. It's not fear-mongering. It's part of the gospel. It's the truth, the whole truth and nothing but the truth. And Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And I'm going to continue always by the grace of God as long as I have breath to give glory to God, even as the Bible says, it says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. And I will praise the Lord at all times, the Bible says. And I will do that by His grace, by His mercy, by His Spirit. I'll continue to do that and lift my voice unapologetic and unpolitically correct. You know, I think Donald Trump, you know, is kind of copying me. You know, I've been unpolitically correct. You know, and that's, you know, Elijah was not politically correct. And in those days, it was not politically correct to talk bad about Jezebel. John the Baptist was not politically correct when he talked about how King Herod had married his brother's wife and that it was a sin and he ought not do it. That's why his brother's wife connived to have John the Baptist's head cut off. King Herod was afraid of John the Baptist, but his brother's wife, who he was living with, she connived with her daughter, the daughter of his brother, you know, his brother's daughter, connived to trick King Herod into promising that he would give her anything that she wanted, and she asked for John the Baptist's head on a silver platter. So this is how that old Jezebel spirit works, trying to shut up the mouth of the prophets. But let me tell you something. Even as the Apostle Paul said, You can put me in jail all you want, but you know the Spirit of God cannot be bound. The Spirit of God cannot be bound. So we cannot. No one can stop what God's going to do. If he can't use me, he'll use somebody else. As Jesus said when he was going up to Jerusalem on Palm Sunday, when the children were crying out, Hosanna to the Son of David, and the Pharisees said, do you hear what these children are saying? You need to tell them to shut up. And Jesus said, if these people be still, even the very rocks would cry out praises to God. Hallelujah. Even as John the Baptist told those old Pharisees, he said, you think that you're somebody special because you say you're the children of God? God can raise up children out of these rocks to worship him, to be his children. God doesn't need any man or any people. We need him. Praise God, brothers and sisters. I came on here to make a video and talk about the new visions and dreams that the Lord has shown me, but the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to preach good news to the poor. Hallelujah. Isaiah 61 and Luke chapter 4, verse 18, as the Lord Jesus Christ declared that word, it was fulfilled in him. Well, we are preachers, and we are the body of Christ. The Spirit of the Lord is upon the body of Christ to preach the good news to the poor, to, you know, to open the eyes of the blind, you know, to lead those captive free, hallelujah, to set the captives free, hallelujah, to open the eyes of the blind and to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Well, brothers and sisters, that year of Jubilee, the acceptable year is almost over. Not a 1 year, the church age, the last 2,000 years has been the year of Jubilee, brothers and sisters. But I'm here to tell you that the door is shutting and is about to shut on that year of Jubilee, the acceptable year of the Lord. For the next verse in Isaiah 61, speaking by the Spirit of the living God, Isaiah said to preach the acceptable year of the Lord and the year of vengeance of our God. Now, brothers and sisters, what we are about to see and what the world is about to see and experience is the year of the vengeance of our God. So some of the bright-minded, carnal-minded, unanointed, uneducated, unlearned people on YouTube, I'm surprised, I'm just thinking now from the Lord, I'm surprised someone hasn't made a video saying, oh, the tribulation is only 1 year long, because the prophet Isaiah, the text that Jesus quoted from in Luke chapter 4, verse 18, it says, and the year of the vengeance of our God, and the acceptable year of the Lord, in the year of the vengeance of our God. So there's only 1 year to get saved and 1 year for tribulation. No, brothers and sisters, the day of the Lord is as 1,000 years with man is a day with the Lord with God. So the 1,000 years, millennial reign of Christ, is the day of the Lord, brothers and sisters. And the year of the vengeance of our God, this is a term meaning that time period. The year of the vengeance of our God, brothers and sisters, is the tribulation period, the vengeance of God. As God said, vengeance is mine, I shall repay. That's why it's not the job of the church. You know, some of these people want to be like James and John, to be sons of thunder. They wanted to call down fire upon the people in Samaria because they wouldn't receive Jesus. And they said, Jesus, these people won't receive you. You want us to call down fire from heaven? Jesus said, you don't know what spirit you are from. I didn't come, you know, to condemn men, that people, but to save people. So that is the church age, the age of Yeshua HaMashiach, this season that we're in, this year of Jubilee, for since the day of Pentecost until today, brothers and sisters, we have found ourselves just by sheer grace and mercy that we've been alive during this age of grace, this church age, this special dispensation, this special season of pardon. God has offered us this jubilee of pardon to the Gentile nations. Brothers and sisters, the jubilee that God has extended to the Gentile nations is coming to a close. Immediately. ASAP. It's over with. The day is at hand. The hour is at hand. It's time for us to depart out of this world just like Jesus departed out of this world. And we're going to come back with him to rule and reign, as it says in Jude, spoken of actually by seventh from Adam. Enoch prophesied that the Lord would return with 10,000s of his saints, straight out of the book of Enoch, written for us in the book of Jude. The Lord will return with us, and we will rule and reign with Christ during the day of the Lord, that 1,000-year reign of Christ. So brothers and sisters, I ask you right now to join me. Join me in this opportunity, in this season of time for departure. I ask you to join me in making our peace with God, setting our house in order. And that's the word from the Lord. Set your house in order. That's the thus saith the Lord. Set your house in order. Prepare to meet thy God. Lift up the feeble knees. Make the crooked path straight. Move forward in paths of righteousness. For our God is a consuming fire. And he's about to consume this world, brothers and sisters. As the Lord had told me, I got so many words every day. Brother Gary Bear and I have been praying and been getting all these words from the Lord's and from the Lord, and I don't know what all he wants to say, but God is going to scorch the earth in this United States, brothers and sisters. The earth is going to be scorched, and it's upon us. It's the tribulation is coming. I had a dream that I want to tell you about. Now that that's what I came on here for. Just got through doing a little preaching from our Lord. I had a dream last night. And in that dream, brothers and sisters, there was the wife, American wife of a prophet of God, a modern day a watchman, one of the watchmen that I know. And I've never met the wife, but I knew who she was in the dream. I had a dream, brothers and sisters, that I was talking with this brother about the return of the Lord. This brother in the Lord, a watchman. And there was a TV. And on this TV was this brother's wife. And she was dressed as a Muslim. And in front of her, she was seated at a table. And in front of her was a sword, a Muslim sword. And a copy of the Quran was open. And that sword was on top of the Quran. And she was wearing a headdress and all this, but her face was uncovered like a burqa, but it was pulled back. And she was saying that we're going to wipe Israel off the face of the map. We're going to destroy Israel and we're going to, you know, make this our land and conquer it and all these things. Like she was a Muslim leader. And then this brother said to her and called her by name. He said to her, hey, what do you, you know, he called her by name. That's how I knew she was because I knew her name. Never saw her before. He called her by name and said, what are you doing? Why are you doing this? And she was able to hear us and talk to us through the TV, looked at him and looked at me and repeated again and kept saying how they're going to destroy Israel. We're going to attack Israel and destroy Israel. You know, like but people talk about this Psalm 83 war or the war of Gog and Magog or whatever. Psalm 83 war, maybe, that people talk about. I don't see it in the text, but maybe. So, Muslim nations. And so I woke up. Oh, before I woke up, brothers and sisters, what really it woke me up was is that a red circle, like this person was in a video on the screen, a little bit lower than where I've got this screen right here, you know, something like this, and or lower, like you could see the table in front of those guy, this brother's wife. There was a red circle, a big red circle in front of her, and around the edge was kind of gold, and then it was there and blocking her, and then I couldn't hear her anymore. And then it flipped. A total of four. There was a total of four of these big red circles. And I immediately knew, hey, that's the four blood moons. That's the four blood moons. Now, the fourth blood moon, of course, is coming up in September. I forgot the day. I think it's September 23rd or 24th, whatever it is. Whatever. It's the blood moons. And then when I woke up, I was like, why is it this dude's wife? And then this brother's wife, and the Lord immediately spoke to me, she is of the spirit of Antichrist. This woman is a God hater. I mean, you know, she is just gets berserk when she hears about God. And just like the Muslims are berserk when they hear about the God of the Bible, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the God of Israel, of Yeshua. So she was representing the fact that this woman, you know, the word for that brother is, hey, your wife is of the spirit of Antichrist. She hates God. She doesn't hate you. Because she contends with her husband every day about serving God to the point where it's just like hell on earth for this brother. And I'm not going to say his name. I ask you to pray for him. You probably don't know him. I ask you to pray for him. And anyway, so, you know, the word that I gave this brother was is that, she hates God, not you. You know, it's God in you that she hates. She's an antichrist. And then, of course, Islam is antichrist. You know, it's not the Antichrist, but anyone that hates Jesus is against Jesus is Antichrist, is of the spirit of the devil, Satan, Lucifer, Antichrist. And so, I believe, you know, from my dream, I don't know if it'll be the day of the fourth blood moon or right after that, the result. You know, they say in the tradition of Israel that in their writings, or their ancient writings of the rabbis, which is not in the Bible, but their tradition is when there's a blood moon seen from Israel, it's a bad omen for Israel, and a solar eclipse is a bad sign for the Gentile nations. Well, there'll be a solar eclipse actually the day the Pope is speaking at the UN or at the Congress. I can't remember which one. There's a solar eclipse in that time frame too, in September. And then there'll be this blood moon that will be seen in lots of places, including Israel. And so, brothers and sisters, you know, I believe that's what's going to happen. This is a road sign from the Lord. Now, people have been watching my videos for a long time, way back. Before I got on YouTube, the Lord led me through a series of dreams to get on YouTube in 2011, July 2011. And I've got videos, and I've got the links before. Since 2011, I've been making videos of the dream I had. I had two dreams that led me to start my YouTube channel. One of the dreams was this. I dreamed, you know, because the Lord had already been speaking to me in my heart and prompting me to get on YouTube. And because there's so much nonsense and false doctrine and no rapture and all of this nonsense of these silly people on YouTube trying to be prophets of God and they're not called to be preachers or prophets or anything. False doctrines. And so anyhow, there were all these people standing around. It was like a war room, and it had a big map of the world on a table. You know, like in a movie where they'll show they have a table, and then they got people that's got little sticks, and they move the little pieces around of the army fighting on this world, like World War II and all that. It was like a big map of the world. And all these people around there debating about the rapture. There is a rapture. There is no rapture. It was just chaos. And the Lord spoke to me and said, speak up. You know the truth. Speak up. You know the right answer. Speak up and tell them. You know what to say. So I started speaking in just a normal voice, and they were shouting over me. And then I kept raising my voice. And finally, I began to really yell, and then they began to look at me and listen to me, kind of like what I'm doing in this video. And everyone got quiet, and they listened to me. And just as they were listening to me, and I was telling them there will be a rapture, and then the tribulation, and, you know, people are right with God to make it in the rapture, you know, to be, you know, like a Luke 21:36 and Revelation 3:10. Jesus said, because you have patiently kept my word, I will keep you out of the hour of temptation to come upon the whole world to try all those that dwell on the earth. Not because you're born again, but you have patiently kept my word, or kept the word of my patience in the King James. And I was saying that, and then we heard an explosion. Everybody looked, and on that map, brothers and sisters, on the Korean Peninsula, there was a nuclear explosion. And on that map, it was like a little mushroom cloud, you know, a little cute little mushroom cloud. I could see it on the table. And that's when I woke up. That's one of the two dreams the Lord gave me. Both of the dreams, he told me to lift my voice and tell people the truth about the end times, about the tribulation and all that. I've been studying it for years, years and years and years, and even in the ministry. Teaching seminars in the Philippines on the end time to pastors. And I've been studying it, you know, really started when I was a teenager. So anyway, brothers and sisters, I've got videos that I've put up periodically over the years about that. And it's, you know, I just heard today, of course, another brother who's also a watchman sent me a link of that, you know, they're escalating tensions there. Now, they've had escalated tensions before, but it's God's timing, brothers and sisters, that we haven't had nuclear explosions in war since World War II. It's only a miracle of God that we haven't had nuclear destruction in this world. But that time seems to be at hand, brothers and sisters. The day of the Lord is upon us. That's the word of the Lord. The day of the Lord is upon us. And God, just like these words I'm giving you, just like what God's going to do in Israel, and the Lord is reminding me, in Ezekiel 38 and 39, when these Muslims try to attack, you know, the war of Gog and Magog, the Russians and the Persians and those other people, they try to attack Israel. It says that God will destroy five-sixths of their army. Excuse me, that's in the King James translation. Taken from the Masoretic text, which is an accurate copy back to the Dead Sea Scrolls. The amount that will be destroyed. And it says that God will, so that the world may know that there is a God in Israel. And that's the message. That's why God does signs and wonders. That's why he heals people. That's why people speak in tongues and people can hear it. Someone interprets and all that. Prophecies, words of wisdom, words of knowledge, healings, miracles, signs and wonders in the heavens, all those things. God doing what he's going to do to those wicked hordes of antichrists that will attack Israel, the war of Gog and Magog, is that the world may know that there is a God in Israel. And he is the only God, the one and only God, hallelujah, the most high God, Elyon, creator of heaven and earth. El Shaddai, God Almighty is his name. Hallelujah. God Almighty is his name. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord, God most high, creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. And praise his only begotten son. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. God bless you all. God bless you all by the grace of God. By the grace of God, brothers and sisters, I'll be back on to make more videos. May the peace of the Lord be with you. Go in peace, knowing that God is on the throne. And, you know, I want to say that right now, too. He'll never leave you nor forsake you, the Lord promised us. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Now, the Bible says that the fearful will not enter the kingdom of heaven. You talk about liars and all this thing. It says the fearful. Now, fear and doubt and unbelief is the opposite of faith. Fear not. The Lord told us to fear not. I've overcome the world. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. And I'll be with you always, even to the end of this church age. He's with us. And then we're going to be with him. Put your faith and trust in the Lord. The truth of God is not to put fear. The truth of God puts fear in those who are unrepentant, to the lost, to those who are backslidden. It's fear, and they need to be afraid. Be very afraid of the vengeance of your God. But if you are prayed up and packed up and looking up, you're going up. So don't be like Peter when he stepped on the water. When he saw the storm, he started sinking. And the Lord asked him, why did you doubt, O ye of little faith? Without faith, it's impossible to please God. And he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Hebrews 11:7. Put your faith and trust in the Lord right now, 100%. Hold on to the hem of his garment. Walk by faith and not by sight. Because we're about to just be right at the precipice of the valley of the shadow of death. And as the Lord spoke to us through the 23rd Psalm, the Shepherd's Psalm, he said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why? Why? Because thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. That's what the Lord does. He leads us into paths of righteousness for his name's sake. He anoints our heads with oil. Hallelujah. He leads us beside the still water. So even as he goes on to say, surely goodness and mercy, you know, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. It's the promise of God, like in John 14. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am you may be also. Hallelujah. I will come again and receive you unto myself. The Lord promised us, and God is not a man that he should lie. So put your faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. Stop running to and fro like a chicken with your head cut off and acting like some kind of an unbelieving clown. A Christian is supposed to have the fruit of the Spirit, and one of those is peace. Peace, be still. Peace be with you. Jesus said, my peace I give unto you. Not the kind of peace that the world has. Not as the world gives, give I unto you. But my peace. And the Bible says, make all your cares and requests be made known to God. And the peace of God that passes all understanding, you know, shall be on you. God will give you his peace. He gave us his peace. Jesus gave the church his peace when he departed at the Last Supper. Rest in Christ. Cast all your cares upon him, for he cares for us. God bless, brothers and sisters.